The wave is traveling in the positive x direction. You can see here. Yeah. So you can see here the direction of wave is this. And E field is red color. This is E field. Okay. And this is B field. Okay. And the angle between E field and B field is 90 degree. Okay. This is 90 degree between electric field and a magnetic field. Okay, and both fields are perpendicular to the direction of propagation, with this direction and this direction. So both electric field and a magnetic field are perpendicular because direction of propagation is along this x direction. So this is direction of propagation. This is direction of propagation along this direction. So electric field and magnetic field, both fields are in phase. Okay, in phase means both are changing. They have same low value and a high value at this at any instant of the time. If you take any instant of time, then you will observe both will have same value. Their values are means changing simultaneously in phase. Okay. And so E y component here, E has E is along y component. And B is along Z component. Okay. So these are few basics of electromagnetic waves, that the solutions of Maxwell's third and the fourth equation are wave-like, where both E and B satisfy the same wave equation. Okay. So this is when you solve the Maxwell's fourth, third and the fourth equation, then you will get that will give solution. Their solutions will be like the wave equation. Okay, so wave equation is a equation from which you can get the velocity and all amplitude and a solution of that wave equation, describe the wave, traveling wave. Like that, if you solve the Maxwell's third and the fourth equation, you will get electric field, magnetic field, values of these components, and all properties contained in the wave equation you can find from the wave equation. Okay. So wave equation, you can find the solution of wave equation. So electromagnetic waves travel through empty space with the speed of light. So electromagnetic wave speed that we have already calculated, that is this formula, that is C is equal to 1 over under root mu naught epsilon naught, and they travel empty space with that. But if you change the medium, then their speed will be decreased. Okay, so we will discuss that later, that how medium affects the electromagnetic wave. When a medium is placed inside electromagnetic wave, then this changes the speed of electromagnetic wave. The electric and the magnetic field components of plane electromagnetic waves are perpendicular to each other. Okay, and a perpendicular to the direction of propagation. We already discussed that fact that electric field, the direction of propagation is always perpendicular to electric field and a magnetic field. Okay. And the relative magnitudes of E and B in empty space are related by this equation. Okay. This is equation that relates the magnitudes of E and B. You cannot compare electric field and a magnetic field because electric field has different units and a magnetic field has different units. So both quantities are different, entirely different. So we may not compare different quantities, okay, but we can compare the same quantities such as energy in electric field and energy in magnetic field. So both fields carry same energy density, but we cannot compare the electric component and a magnetic component of the electromagnetic wave. So their energy density is same, electric field density energy density is same, and the magnetic field energy density is same. We will later discuss. Okay, electromagnetic waves also obey principle of superposition. It means when there are large number of electromagnetic waves, for example, at this point, if large number of electromagnetic waves are coming, okay, then you can just add the you can take resultant as sum of all these waves. So there is known as principle of superposition. If you want to calculate anywhere at any point where many electromagnetic waves are coming, then you may add all these waves individually. So each wave will not influence other wave. So resultant will be the sum of all waves. So this is equation for E and a B field. Okay, these are solutions of the wave equation. So these are solution. This is the equation that define the electric component of the wave equation. That is because E is along y direction, so there is EY and the propagating along the x direction and the changing with time. Function of x and the t, so it is changing with x and the t, and e maximum means amplitude. Okay, so it is varying with cos kx. K is a wave vector. Okay, it shows a direction of wave in which wave k is moving. K value of k is 2 pi over lambda. And omega is angular frequency. Okay. So angular frequency, radians per second. Okay. And this k means radian per meter. Okay. So this is k is a direction of k is along the direction of the wave in which wave is moving. Okay. So this defines the electric component of the electromagnetic wave. And also there will be another component that will be magnetic field. So this is magnetic field. As you know that magnetic field is along z direction. We already seen that you can see in this picture that B is along z direction and E is along E is this direction, that is along the y direction. Okay, so both are changing with the x. This is x and the time as you move in this direction, time is changing and the x is also changing. So wave electric field is also function of x and the t, that is given by E maximum. Okay, E maximum means electric field that is maximum amplitude, and there is cos kx minus omega 2. And magnetic field is also changing with time. So you can see the magnetic field is along z direction and it is changing with x and time. Okay. So both equations Ey x t, so these both equations describe electric field component and a magnetic field component of electromagnetic wave. Okay. So you know that there are few terms that describe the wavelengths, such as wavelength is a term that defines, that is, distance between two crests or two troughs. So this is distance, or you can say the wavelength is a distance between the points which are in same phase, which are in phase. Okay, so this point and this points are in phase, so the distance between two points in phase is known as also wavelength. Okay.
Sir, phase, what is phase, sir?
Phase means the point where they are moving in the same direction, because you know that at this location you can see the points have same motion, same direction, and at this point wave is also moving in same direction. So it means that both have same direction of motion, both are moving, this point is also moving in this direction, this point is also moving in this direction, and both are at the maximum amplitude, at maximum displacement from the mean position. So it means they are both in phase. But if you take this point, then this point and this point are in different direction, means this is moving in up direction and this is coming in down direction. So both have different motion, so they are not in phase. Okay, so wavelength is a distance between two crests or two troughs, are the points where which are in phase. Distance between, it is a distance, lambda is measured in meters because it is distance. The frequency is a number of cycles per second, okay, on the wave passes through a cycle. You can calculate the frequency of a wave by just looking at one point, how many waves, complete waves across that point. If one wave complete means which is one crest and one trough, this is complete wave because it is one trough and one crest. So if this wave crosses in 1 second, okay, one wave crosses in 1 second, it means one cycle per second, means it has one frequency, 1 hertz, one cycle per second. But two waves cross in 1 second, it means it has 2 cycles per second frequency. Okay, 2 cycles per second. But if half wave crosses in 1 second, that it has half frequency. Okay, so when, how many number of waves cross from a given point in 1 second, that is known as its frequency. So it is measured also in hertz. So 1 cycle per second is equal to 1 hertz. So 1 cycle per second is equal to 1 hertz. Hertz is also unit of frequency. So you know that there are different kinds of electromagnetic waves, and there is a spectrum that where we define different kind of waves. So each different kind of wave is produced by different force, okay, and each has same velocity, okay, but their wavelength and their frequency are different, okay. So only the wave which we can, the frequency that we can see, that we can our mind can interpret, is visible light, okay. So this is the only part that is visible light, that is from 700 nanometer to 400 nanometer, whose wavelength is 700 nanometer to 400 nanometer. Only we can see, we can see only these colors, okay. So this color, that is violet, okay. So it is highest frequency and the lowest wavelength. Frequency and wavelength are inversely proportional. Means waves whose wavelength is greater, its frequency will be lower. Okay. So red has 700 nanometer. Okay. It means its wavelength is higher. So its frequency will be lower. Okay. And violet light has 400 nanometer. It means it is frequency will be larger than red light. Okay, so frequency and a wavelength are inversely proportional. Means the wave whose wavelength is greater, its frequency will be low. Okay, so visible light can be obtained by the optical transitions of outer shell electrons. So the electrons, when transit from one shell to another shell, a light is first they are excited and then they come back. So these are frequencies and these are wavelengths, and you can see that here only we can see this narrow band of visible light, but we cannot see infrared or microwaves or TV radio waves. Okay, so these waves we cannot see, and their wavelength, as we come in this direction, their wavelength increases. So radio wave have large wavelength and frequency decreases. As we come in this direction, wavelength increases and a frequency decreases, because when wavelength will increase, frequency will decrease. So radio TV uses these waves, or mobile communication uses microwaves. Okay, so these are waves that are used by TV communication or mobile communication, radio waves and FM radio, that these waves are used by radio communication or telecommunication. Okay, and infrared light, they whose wavelength is greater than red color, that are usually emitted by hard bodies, as night goggles. There are night goggles that you can see a person when there is no light in the night, using night goggles, because night goggles capture these infrared radiations. These infrared radiations are emitted by hard bodies, the bodies whose temperature is greater than 0 Kelvin. All bodies emit radiation. Their radiation is infrared radiation. So infrared radiation is emitted by all hard bodies, and that can be captured by a camera. These are the known as night vision cameras. You can see at night by using that electromagnetic radiation. Okay. And ultraviolet light, there is whose frequency is greater than visible light, violet light, and whose wavelength is less than this light, means violet light. It is more powerful. It can cause cancer also. It is emitted by the sun. Okay, and then we will discuss also X-rays. X-rays, you can say, you can also produce X-rays. X-rays are more powerful rays than ultraviolet light, and X-rays also can be emitted by a few stars such as pulsars. So these X-rays can be produced by when electrons are accelerated. These their kinetic energy is converted into X-rays. Okay, and then we have gamma rays. Gamma rays are emitted by nuclear isotopes such as uranium. These are emitted from the nucleus, so they are more powerful. Their power is more than all electromagnetic waves. So there is a electromagnetic spectrum. So now we will discuss energy in electromagnetic waves. How much energy they contain? Okay. So energy in electromagnetic waves, you know that we have discussed this term also. This term says that the energy density in electric field is equal to 1 over 2 epsilon naught E square. So UE is a energy density. Okay. Energy density in electric field. Okay. So there is amount of energy 1 over 2 pi epsilon naught E square. And energy density that magnetic field carries is equal to this amount. This is the energy that a magnetic field has. This amount of energy contained into magnetic field that is given by mu b is equal to 1 over 2 mu naught b square. So total energy is given by, because electromagnetic wave, both electric field and a magnetic field. So total energy contained by both field is given by this. Okay, this term and this term. This is for B field, magnetic field, and this is for electric field. This is total energy inside the electromagnetic wave. But you know that both energies are equivalent. Energy density, the carried by electric field, and energy density by carried by magnetic field. Both energies are equivalent. So you can also put here, you know that B is equal to E over C. Okay, because we have already derived that E is equal to BC. Okay, and we know that C is equal to 1 over under root mu naught and epsilon naught. Okay, so that is the value of C. So if you put here E over 1 over under root mu naught epsilon naught, so that will give E under root mu naught epsilon naught, or you can write E in front of this equation. Okay, so this is the expression that is for B. Okay, so if you put this value in this equation, okay, so this is same, and we put this value that is given by B. Okay, so we have put this value in this equation. In this equation, okay, in this equation, so we have put value of B here. Okay, so here this value of B is there, so its square will be equal to, you can see here mu naught is cancelled, and this becomes mu naught cancels, and this term, this is magnetic field, so this was first 2 mu naught and B square. Now this term becomes equal to 1 over 2 epsilon naught and E square. So this is same as energy in electric field. So this energy is same that is in electric field. So both fields contain the same amount of energy, electric field and a magnetic field. So electric field has same energy and a magnetic field has same energy. So we can replace the magnetic energy density by this term. Okay, so if we put that term here, so the total energy will be equal to half in magnetic field and half in electric field. So total energy will be this amount of it. That is the energy density contained into electric field and a magnetic field. So there is energy density of for the electromagnetic wave. So this term is energy density for in electromagnetic waves. If you consider when wave is propagating, electromagnetic wave is propagating in x direction. For example, here a figure is given. This is a figure which shows that electromagnetic wave is traveling relative to this stationary. So this is stationary wavefront. So the distance between this and this is, already we have discussed, that is c dt. And a wave is traveling in this direction. Okay, so electric field is in upward direction and a magnetic field is coming in sideways. Okay, so both fields are perpendicular and this direction is direction of propagation. Okay. So we define means whenever they pass through across any area, they provide or they put their energy in that region. They transfer their energy in that medium. Okay. So because they carry the energy, electromagnetic waves have energy. Okay. So whenever they cross a certain region or certain surface, they transfer their energy. And that energy, you can calculate how much energy they transfer through any surface or through any small area. Okay, so you can calculate that amount of energy. How you can calculate? There is a, this is the amount of energy. For example, this is du is the amount of energy that is transferred by these waves given any cube or any region. So that you can calculate, that is means this is energy transferred. So that is given by this u, small u, that is energy content into the electromagnetic waves. Okay. And ACDT, that is area of the region, and CTDT means the distance, means this is volume. Okay? This is volume, any given volume. So you can calculate that okay. So this is
sir?
Yes
sir, aapne wo u kya bataya, u kya cheez hai,
बड़ा यू या छोटा यू?
छोटा वाला यू।
छोटा, ये एनर्जी डेंसिटी है इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव, ठीक, जो एनर्जी जो इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव्स में है वो एनर्जी, और ये जो बड़ा यू है, देयर इज एनर्जी ट्रांसफर्ड इनटू द क्यूब एनी सर्टेन रीजन और एनी सर्टेन वॉल्यूम, किसी वॉल्यूम में से जो एनर्जी ट्रांसफर हो रही है वो डी यू, बड़ा डी यू है, ठीक है।
तो सर जो ए होगा वो तो
एरिया
होगा,
एरिया एरिया से सी डी टी डी मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे तो फिर वो हो जाएगा वॉल्यूम। तो इस रीजन का पूरे का जो वॉल्यूम होगा, ये पूरे रीजन का जो वॉल्यूम होगा, इसके अंदर जो है ये पूरा ये वॉल्यूम है, ठीक है, ये पूरा वॉल्यूम है, ये पूरा इसके अंदर जो एनर्जी जो ट्रांसफर होगी दैट इज डी यू, और जो u है वो वेव में, स्मॉल u जो है देयर इज एनर्जी इन द कंटेंट इन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव, और एरिया a देयर इज द रीजन ऑफ सरफेस एरिया ऑफ दैट क्यूब और एनी रीजन, एंड ctdt देयर इज डिस्टेंस। ओके, सो दैट एनर्जी विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड अक्रॉस एनी surface or any you know that whenever in electromagnetic waves light strikes any wall or any metal, you know that it gets heated. Okay, so why it gets heated? Because it absorbs energy, it absorbs energy from the sun. So sun emits electromagnetic waves, and they whenever these electromagnetic waves strike any surface, they transfer energy. Okay, that energy is transferred into, how much energy is transferred in that material, we are calculating that. Okay, so the direction in which energy is transferred, that is perpendicular to the electric field and a magnetic field, and there is known as pointing vector. So S here, S shows the direction of propagation of energy, the direction in which energy is transferred. Okay, so energy is transferred in this direction, in S direction. S is known as pointing vector. Okay, so pointing vector S is defined as energy transferred ट्रांसफर्ड पर यूनिट एरिया एंड पर यूनिट टाइम. So there is the definition of pointing vector. So pointing vector actually shows you how much energy is transferred by electromagnetic energy per unit area per unit time. Here, so here you can read energy in region defined by A by CTD will be energy that passed through area A. Okay, so energy in the region in which we are discussing, in which electromagnetic waves are transferring their energy, is the energy density multiplied by the volume. Okay, so we multiplied the energy density with the volume, and we found how much energy is transferred in that region. Okay, so already we discussed this point. Okay, so this is U, energy density, this is energy density, and this is volume in which energy is transferred, that is given by AC dt. Okay, so this is the amount of energy density in U. Okay, the energy per unit time through A, it will be, so you can calculate that du over dt per unit time, how much energy will be transferred per unit time, then we will divide dt on both sides, so this becomes dt, dt cancels, so only here this term is remaining. So this is energy per unit time, and energy per unit time per area will be, this is energy per unit time. Okay, but the energy that is transferred per unit time, but the energy transferred per unit time per unit area, then we will divide time area also, so area will be cancelled. Okay, here will be also area. So that is, this term is defined as energy transfer per unit area per unit time is known as pointing vector. Okay, this is definition of pointing vector. So pointing vector is given by this formula, and a pointing vector also can be written in terms of B. Okay, so in terms of B we can write it as follows. Okay, so this is represented by S, so you can give here this term. Is S is a pointing vector, so S is a pointing vector, and its unit is watt per meter square, how many watts are absorbed by any surface per unit area per unit time. Okay, so it also, S also divided can be defined as power per unit time. Okay, power transfer per unit time. Okay, this is power per unit time is known as S. So this is also definition of S. Yeah. So you can see that S is equal to epsilon naught E square into C, and you can also use E as 1 over, this is formula for E is equal to, because E equal to CB, and here C equal to 1 over mu naught epsilon naught into B. So you can put value of E in this equation. Okay. So now S can be written as like this, because S is equal to epsilon naught E square into C. So we can write E is 2 times, so 1 E is replaced by this value, okay, 1 over mu naught epsilon naught B to C, and this will become this is a value, okay, epsilon naught over mu naught epsilon naught EB, okay, and this becomes finally this value, okay, and epsilon naught cancels, and this is 1 over mu naught EB. This is known as Poynting vector, okay, S is a Poynting vector. Okay. So this is the value of Poynting vector. So we can also write S is 1 over mu naught E cross B. Okay. So because its direction is given by right hand rule, stretch your fingers in direction of electric field and a curl in direction of B, you will find the direction of S perpendicular to E and B, electric field and a magnetic field. So this is the magnitude of S. This is magnitude of S. S is equal to EB over mu naught. So this is magnitude. Okay. And we discussed direction. Okay. So this is the definition of S Poynting vector. Poynting vector, that is energy per unit time passing through any area with an electromagnetic wave. Means the energy that is transferred by any electromagnetic wave is known as S Poynting vector. Okay, so we define a vector, the Poynting vector, to be. So now this is the definition of Poynting vector. S is equal to 1 over mu naught E cross B. So direction of Poynting vector is the direction of propagation of the wave. The magnitude of Poynting vector is the energy per unit time per unit area. There is power per unit. We have already described that this is the definition of Poynting vector. Also, it is definition is power per unit area delivered by the wave. How much energy power a wave delivers per unit time is known as Poynting vector. Okay. You can also calculate it is average power. Okay, because wave is changing very fast, so you can calculate its average power. So you can take its average power by putting these values, this equation for E and this equation for B, okay. So you can put these equations. Here in this formula, yeah. So you can put these both equations in this bar for E and for B. So you can calculate total energy. So the magnitude of S will be equal to, so these both equations we have put for E and for B, and we will take their average. Okay, so average of this and average of this, because waves are changing very fast. E maximum we will not change this value, and B maximum only, because cos, we will take average of cos kx minus omega t and a cos kx minus omega t. So that average will be equal to, that is equal to, because cos multiplied when that becomes cos square kx. Okay. So this is equal to cos square kx minus omega t. That is, we multiplied cos with cos. So this becomes, when we multiplied that, because it is average of this is equal to 1 over 2. Okay, so average of this term is 1 over 2. Okay, so S becomes E maximum. This is average value. Okay, so you can represent with a line E maximum and a B maximum divided by 2 mu naught. So this is average value of S, and this is also known as intensity of a wave. Okay, so we describe the intensity of wave. So average value of a pointing vector is known as intensity. Okay, so we discussed this average cycle. So this is S average. This is S average. This is intensity of electromagnetic wave. Definition of intensity. Okay. So there is S average intensity. Okay. So if you have any question up to now, please ask. So radiation pressure means energy that is transferred into any medium or any material that exerts a pressure, a kind of pressure, radiation pressure. Means the whenever an electromagnetic wave strikes any material, it exerts force on that medium. Okay, that exerts force on that region, that body. Okay, so electromagnetic pressure is defined as, because pressure, you know that what is pressure? Pressure is force, momentum is known as force. P is a momentum. Okay, P is a momentum. So it is known as dP over dt. That is Newton's second law. That is equal to F. So F is equal to rate of change of momentum. So whenever there will be a momentum, there will be a force. So whenever a electromagnetic wave strikes any surface, it exerts a momentum, and a momentum changes and it exerts force on that surface. Okay, so we say that the moment pressure that is equal to we have two kinds of condition when an electromagnetic wave strikes any surface. One moment is that when it strikes this object, it is totally absorbed. Totally absorbed. And other situation is that when it gets reflected. Okay, so in both cases, different amount of pressure is exerted on the body. Yeah, so total momentum delivered when there is total absorption, there will be P will be equal to, P is a momentum, that will be U per C. Okay, so this is momentum when object absorbs complete radiation. Okay, so wave is EM wave is completely absorbed. And other situation is that when you have kind of object, when electromagnetic wave absorbs, strikes with this surface and then returns back, reflects back, then the amount of momentum that is transferred, that will be equal to 2 U over C. This equation has been taken from E is equal to mc square. Okay, you can write this equation as E is equal to, c is the speed of light, and you can write here mc c. And mc is a mass into velocity, that is equal to momentum p. So e we can write E as a P into C. P is a momentum. So PC, here you can write P as E over C. Okay. So momentum equal to energy over C. So here U is a energy. Okay. So this is the term when yes, Akhil. Okay, so this is the momentum when the light wave is completely reflected. Okay. So that was your, so this is E maximum and E B maximum. Okay. These are values of S average, means intensity. This is also known as intensity. Okay. And we can also write these EM and BM in terms of average values, RMS values. Okay. So we can write EM average maximum is equal to under root 2 into ERMS. Root mean square values. Okay. So root mean square values are found like this. ERMS. They are found like E maximum when you E maximum divides with under root 2, that is known as ERMS. Why we calculate ERMS? Because when you take average of any wave, that becomes zero, because positive and a negative values are same, equal. But when you take ERMS, you take average of all values and find its square. Okay, RMS. Okay, means you give a square on these values and then find its root. Okay, so that value is known as RMS value. Okay? So whenever you want to find the RMS value, okay? So you give, you divide by square 2. Okay, so now if you put that value in this equation, okay, so you can find the S average value of S average. So our S average is 1 over 2 mu naught EM and BM, and now we will put the values of E average. E maximum is equal to under root 2, okay, and ERMS, and B maximum is under root 2 BRMS. Okay, so this will become 1 over 2 mu naught, and here it will become 2 because under root 2 from EM and under root, and this will becomes ERMS and BRMS. Okay, so 2 cancels, and this becomes 1 over mu naught ERMS and BRMS. So this is intensity, average intensity.